What's your take? Do you think MFM can hold on to that leading audience? Talk to us. I want to hear from you on Twitter channels, underscore sports, Facebook channels, IFS Sports. So MFM holds the lead. One Nigerian team. The other Nigerian team in the CAF Champions League is Plateau United, defending champions of the league. And they lost 4-2 in the first leg in Tunisia. Alfred, I think that's a more difficult game because Etoile du Sahel comes with massive experience in this competition. But hey, it's football. I think if they give us that same approach they gave 10 minutes to the end of that first leg in Tunisia, they can just win it here.
That game is scheduled to be played at the Sani Abacha Stadium in Kano, and not the new Just Stadium. I don't know why all of the changes. If Edin Sports from Cameroon were good enough to play in Just, perhaps maybe CAF would have seen one or two things that that he just didn't like about that.
Get the perimeter fencing done, and they gave the management of Plateau United enough time. So that is what we're talking about. Playing at the continent is not just about the coaches
now,
and the players.
I think taking them to Kano has left them shorthanded. They just have all, but looking at it, they did themselves a whole lot of good by getting those two away goals. It makes the job easier, a bit easier for them, because now if they can keep it tight at the back, perhaps a goal in each half, they will be in the group stage of the competition. I mean, having scored two goals against this Etoile side, yes, Etoile comes with, you know, with pedigree. They come with a lot of experience. Mm. They are, you know, when it comes to campaigning at this level, they are massively experienced in playing at this level. But I think for being champions of Nigerian football, it will be a very, very big disappointment if Plateau United exits this competition at this time. I think they have what it takes to do it.
Yeah.
All those times they used to be like Rangers. Those things they do, let them do it in this game. Mm. Get the result and find themselves in two
stages. So that's what it is. So now you know the faith of the two Nigerian teams in the CAF Champions League. Plateau United lost the first leg 4-2. MFM won the first leg 2-1. MFM has traveled to Algiers for the second leg that will be played tomorrow. Plateau United, they are getting ready. But sad news is that the game will not be played in Jos because they failed to meet the requirements from CAF to be able to play at that new stadium. So they'll be going to the Sani Abacha Stadium in Kano. The good thing is the people of Kano can just turn up for them, but they need to know the field. They need to come out. Losing, they lost the first leg in just 10 minutes. Considered 3 goals in 10 minutes, and that was where they fell down flat. So let's wish them all the best. It's football, anything can happen. It's not just the CAF Champions League. There's also the CAF Confederations Cup, AIMBA, and Aqua United. They will be busy. Aqua United will host Al Ittihad. Second leg, the first leg ended 1-0. So second leg, we played on Sunday, Alfred, at the Godswill Akpabio International Stadium. While AIMBA, against Energy Football Club of Benin Republic, they won the first leg by 2-0. So it looks like it's done and dusted for the People's Elephants.
That game is, as a contest, it's since over after the AIMBA. I had even the luxury of missing the penalty in the first leg. It would have been like three goals up, complete dominance. I don't see any adverse result coming from that game. The team already.
But they cannot afford to be complete.
No, they can't let let anything let their guards down. AIMBA are experienced at this level. I'm not with the pedigree they have on the continent, having won the CAF Champions League twice on the bounce, but those days are it's really this generation of young reporters and young fullers of the MPFL now who looked at very well. Badwere Yimba was really dominant on the continent. This is an opportunity, perhaps maybe not in the Champions League, this is the Confederations Cup, equally lucrative competition. No Nigerian team, the last time they tried in the Confederations Cup, they got some beating from South Africa and Egypt and the rest of them, and teams that pulled out that they couldn't just come out of the group stage. This time around, good result for them. It's in the Confederations Cup. 2 more rounds to get to the group stage, but for them, they know that this one is, for me, done. While in Uyo, Aqua United is on record, they've not won a CAF competition in Uyo. That will make anybody worried.
That they lost the first leg when you least expect them to.
With all of the chances they created. Yeah. No, to be honest, even the Hawks of Togo, Gambia, I beg your pardon, the Hawks of Gambia team, where yes, they won the match going back to their country, but I'm sure they're not too confident given the plethora of chances chances that Akwa United created and missed. I think they just have to find a way of relaxing some more. We know what this team can really do. The potential in this team, the Ole Stemmers of this world, the one that played for Remo Stars, Victor Mboma, what they bring to the table, these are guys who are tested in the Nigerian football sector. And so we know that they can do better than they've done in time past. So our expectations are that Abdul Mekaba will get the best out of these boys. Relax some more. Yes, you won't go down. Relax some more. You need 2 goals to progress in this competition.
That's what it is. So Akwa United also, tricky. It's very tricky for them, particularly what Alfred just said. They need to start winning at the Godswill Akpabio International Stadium. They lost the first leg by a single goal on Sunday. They'll be hoping to turn things around. They have the quality. Akwa United have the quality. They have a sound coach. Hey, the people of Uyo, they need to also come out to support the team. The people of Kano and those around Kano, please come out and support Kano Pillars. Also, those of us that couldn't travel to Algiers or MFM, let's get on our knees and start praying. It's good to see Nigerian teams make it to the group phase of the CAF Champions League. Sports Tonight on Channels Television. Let's bring the conversation back home now at the league that made these teams that are representing Nigeria in the continent now. Let's go on March the 13th of the Nigeria Professional Football League. It's getting interesting, and guys, it is running away. Look at that. Katsina United will host Heartland. Abia Warriors will play Wiki Tourist. Sunshine Stars will take on Yobe Stars, while El Academy Warriors will play Ifeanyi Oba. Just about six fixtures for the week. And Nasarawa United will play Lobi Stars, who are currently on top of the log, while Kano Pillars will take on Niger Tornadoes. So that's it. March the 13th of the Nigeria Professional Football League. Let's go on this quick break now. When we come back, we'll read your tweets and find out what the draw produced for the quarterfinals of the UEFA Champions League and the Europa League. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.